So I received an interesting note on my Facebook page the other day, and it said, hello, very interesting tutorials. Just want to know if you did a tutorial on when you send email with a user form in Excel. Thanks to help me. And so I hadn't done one, but I thought that would be a great idea for a tutorial. And so here we go. So I have just done something very basic. I've got company names, brown, blue, red, orange. And obviously this list would be, as in normal sheets with customer names, this would be thousands and thousands of lines long. You could use customer names instead of customer numbers instead of names, or you could use the contact name and send email. So what I've done here is I've created a user form, and so I'll show you. Let me just get this out of this way. So I've got this button called send and search and send. And so what you're doing is let's type in blue. And then you go find, and then it's going to find the email address for you. So if that maybe isn't the right one that you want, so you can go clear and it's going to empty it. And then let's go red. And once again, find, and it finds the email address for you. So now, if this is the right one and you decide to send an email, you're just going to press this email button, and it's going to open up Outlook, address it to this this company email here. We could put in a standard issue message if you'd like here, but I'm assuming that a unique situation, you'd want to send, put your own subject and title and body in there. When it's ready to go, you simply press send and you're good. So let's show you how I did this. So I'm going to close this down and not save it. Okay, so I'm going to close this down, and then what I'm going to do is the first thing that I did is I inserted a user form. So we'll go to Visual Basic. Okay, so there's my user form. So I just created two fields here and three buttons. And so now let me show you the code for what I've done. So I'm going to double click on the find here to show you the code. And so what it's done here now is it's gone and it's looking, I've declared values here, name, address, range, row number, last row, and X is long. So last row is current region, rows count. So we don't go past there. If text box is empty, oh, I should have shown you that. If you press, so we'll go search and send, and then we go with nothing in there, you click that and it says enter company name, and so you say okay. All right, and then it also, if you've put something in there that's not in the list, it'll come up with or name not found. Okay, so let's go back to the code here. What I've done is last row being the current region's row count, text box, if it's nothing there, then message enter a company name. So X equals 2, because I have headings, and then to the last row for X equals 2, if trim sheet, so we're taking off all the spaces and everything else, cells X1 is not equals trim text box X, and X equals last row. So if you go into the bottom and you don't find it, then you're going to send a message box saying name not found. If trim sheet 1 cells X1 equals trim text box 1. So if they find it, then the text box 1 is what they is what you've entered, and text box 2 is, or text box 2 is the email address. Then I've written a little code here to say to clear the form, and the third bit of code here is to look up the form on the or to send. The third piece of code here is to send an email to the form name, dim, address, and very similar to the rest, set Outlook, create object, Outlook application, set Outlook mail create, and then we say Outlook, and then I've left all of these blank for the fact that I want you to be able to enter the information. And Outlook, and so then when it's all done, set Outlook mail to display, set Outlook Mail to nothing, and that's to clear your Outlook Mail so it doesn't send it more than once. So to create a button, I went to insert, the insert thing on your developer tab here, and then I got this ActiveX command button X control. And then what I did, I basically used the, when you double click it, you create this code, and it says user form one show. So when you click that, it shows the user form on your sheet. So that's how you create a button to, for a user form to send emails to customers that you find from your list. Please subscribe.